Welcome to Decadent Ice Cream. We are going to get into the French method of making decadent ice cream. And what we're going to do is we're going to show you how to cook your eggs in a consistent manner where you're not going to have issues with them, curdling, scrambling, turning them into omelets unintentionally. We're going to show you how to make some really cool ice creams. We're going to show you the method of doing this. You do not need an ice cream machine to do this. Also, too, you see sitting in front of me a very simple dessert, banana bread pudding, and one of the ice creams we're making tonight, banana, raspberry, white chocolate chip. And we've drizzled some chocolate over the top of it, a Belgian chocolate sauce. So you have a really cool, simple dessert, one of the variations that can be made with the ice creams that you're being shown tonight. Now you're probably saying, gee, am I going to be shown the bread pudding tonight? No, you're not. That's with the banana bread recipes video. So there's inspiration to see more than one episode in our series in the public library cooking classes brought to you by freecookingprograms.com. My name is Michael Nixick. Yes, I am a chef. I've appeared on TV hundreds of times. I've had hundreds of newspaper articles written about me. And my wife still hasn't thrown me out of the house. So it's a good thing. And what we're going to do is we're going to be very concise and to the point. All the recipes will be at the end of the video. What we want you to concentrate on during the video is methods. Methods rule, recipes follow suit. Without methods, recipes don't exist. So it's more important to learn your methods than it is to learn a recipe. And that's where we're going with all of the videos in this series. We're going to learn methods, and we're going to understand the methods better to enhance your cooking skills so that you can be more efficient, more productive, and be able to do more things in your own kitchen, make you a more competent, more confident cook, and also too much more popular with everybody that you know, because they'll be looking at your recipes and they'll be going, wow, where'd that come from? So let's get started. Okay, it's time to make some decadent ice cream. We're about to make a banana raspberry white chocolate chip ice cream, and we're even going to put some raspberry dusted almonds in it just for good luck. So what we're going to do first is we're going to make our base. Our base is eggs and sugar and our extracts. Now when I say eggs, I mean egg yolks. And once this is incorporated, which only takes seconds, we're going to add in our half and half and our cream. Now, what we do is we heat up the half and half and the cream on the side until it gets hot separately. And then we bring it back to this mix. And then we cook it slowly on a water bath. The water bath is directly underneath this bowl. Can barely be seen by the camera, but that's okay. And here we have our hot cream. And as we pour it in slowly. And we make sure that we're whipping the entire time, because we don't want to cook and scramble the eggs. We don't want them to what's referred to as curdling, or making an unnecessary omelet. Now, while they are cooking, we want to keep stirring. And we want to do this throughout the bowl. Now, some chefs will tell you that the foam on top of this is unnecessary and you shouldn't have it there. I think quite the opposite. The reason I think the opposite is because when this mixture starts to tighten and thicken, as it will, that foam will start to disappear. That's a tell that you're getting done to finishing cooking the sauce. And it is, in essence, a sauce at this point in time. Now, one of the cool parts about doing it like this is the fact that you can literally check and see how it's being cooked, as far as like how done it is. One of the tells that you look for is the color of the eggs as they're cooking. And if you'll see right now, the camera will pick up the fact that there's a little bit of a translucent color to the eggs and a shine to them. That means that they're not done. The more they get done, the more opaque this color of yellow will be for the sauce. And, of course, it'll start to tighten up. This is your base for the ice cream. after you make your base like this, you can pretty much add any type of flavorings and combinations you want to finish the ice cream. One of the things that you have to keep in mind is that if you're going to be adding specific things to the ice cream, such as garnishes or other types of fruit purees, maybe some melted chocolate, whatever the case may be, always take into account the heat of the sauce or the base as you add the other items to it. In this case, what we're going to be doing is, as soon as this gets done, we're going to whip in our pureed bananas. Our bananas we pureed in our Cuisinart just a few minutes ago, and we're going to dump them in literally in just a couple of minutes, as this is cooking quite quickly. As this cooks, you don't stop stirring. You don't rest your hands, and you don't mess around. Now, one of the things that you notice from the screen is that my wrist doesn't move much. The stirring is done by my hand. My wrist stays in one spot, so basically my arm's not flapping up and down like a chicken trying to fly. And that's a definite tell as to how somebody is trained in a kitchen inside of a restaurant. They're swinging their arm all over the place to stir something. Their teacher wasn't very knowledgeable, or they didn't listen, one or the other. As you can see, it's starting to tighten up. There's less and less egg foam on this, and we can see that this is getting closer and closer to being done. The color is changing, it's becoming more opaque. There's less and less foam. And don't forget that once this starts to freeze, this foam, this will just literally collapse right back into the ice cream. So it doesn't mean anything, so don't even worry about it. And literally, check it out. See how it's changed? Also, another thing that you can look for is any discoloration around the edges. If it's darker around the edges, that means that it's not done. And what I mean by discoloration is two different colors of yellow. The edge around the bowl will be a translucent yellow and a little darker in color, richer in color, and this is going to be more opaque and duller in color. And as you can see, right now, we're done. All finished. And we're going to take our stabilizer out. I'm going to set it down on the counter, and we're going to use it again in just a minute. And we're going to add our bananas. And this is going to actually cool it off some. Now, the reason we're adding our bananas late is that we don't want them to cook and discolor more than they will just by being pureed. Because that will happen. That's natural, so don't worry about it. It's not that they're old. This was just done a couple minutes ago. And you can see how much thicker the sauce, the ice cream got by doing this. And we touch it and we see how warm it is. Ooh, and we see how tasty it is too. Now that you've done that, don't put your finger back in there. All right then. Here's the inside of the bowl. So you can see only a small portion right here stuck to the side of the bowl from being not stirred enough. After that, the entire bowl is nice and clean, which is what you should have. There shouldn't be any lumps in here. It should be nice and clean and smooth. And we're going to finish it off. Our banana ice cream base is ready. And we're going to add to it. And now remember, this is room temperature right now. We're going to add some frozen chopped raspberries to it. You can use fresh. I prefer to use frozen because it gets the process going much more quickly. And all we do is just mix it in easily, simple. Try and make it as evenly dispersed as possible. And then we're going to follow that up with our white chocolate chips. And then we're going to finish it off with some raspberry covered almonds. These have a dusted raspberry chocolate coating, and we'll add a fine garnish to our ice cream. And we'll move this over, drop some more in because we never want to be short of garnishes. We're done. Simple and to the point. All you have to do is just push these in just a touch. And then when you take an ice cream scoop to it, you'll get everything in each and every scoop that you take. And with a flat, low container like this, it'll freeze very, very quickly and very evenly. And if you have any thoughts about all the items sinking to the bottom possibly on you, when it's halfway frozen, you know, check into it about maybe an hour or so into the process. Give it a stir. Nice gentle stir around the edges and push them in towards the center and move it around a little bit, nice and gentle and slow. And you're all set and ready to rock and roll. Easy. No big deal. Okay, we're back to square one. This is our next batch of ice cream. And we're going to make ridiculously strawberry ice cream. And we are going to start with our base, as we did before. And we're going to be using yolks and strawberry liqueur and sugar and lemon juice. And once this gets to temperature, we're going to add our heavy cream. And then we're going to finish it off with strawberry puree. Strawberry puree was literally made separately and ahead of time. Very, very easy. Take the strawberries, cleaned, and sugar, and a little bit of fruit juice, and you bring it to a boil, and you cook them until they're nice and strong in flavor. You cool them off, and then you puree them. And you strain the pips out of them. Then you have a nice concentrated strawberry flavor. And then once we get all this in, we're going to add some dark chocolate chips, and we're going to add some whole frozen strawberries as well, too. They've been chopped up a little bit. And here comes our heavy cream. And again, constantly whipping it while you're adding it, because we don't want to scramble the eggs. There we go. And we are going to continue stirring this until the yolks are done and it starts to thicken and the foam subsides. And when it gets to that point, we're going to add some more strawberry liqueur, because while we're doing it now, the strawberry liqueur that's in there, the alcohol is what you see evaporating first and foremost. And then after that, more of the liquids will actually start to evaporate as this gets cooked. This way, we'll have a reduction in the amount of actual alcohol that's in the ice cream. Yeah, I know some of you will say, oh, that's not good. Some of you will say, oh, that's good. So we're going to meet in a happy medium ground. What we started with as far as the alcohol goes, we're going to knock the alcohol out of it by cooking it. And then we're going to add more alcohol and more of the strawberry liqueur to this with the puree. And in doing so, we'll have a little bit of an alcohol taste to it. Plus the alcohol that we add in the liqueur will help keep the ice cream from getting hard as brick. Now, one of the things you want to remember is, since we're not whipping air into this, it's going to be firmer when it freezes. But that's okay. A couple of things can be done. You can actually take it and put it onto a inside of a bowl for a KitchenAid, and using a paddle, knock some air into it and whip it, and then put it back into the freezer. Don't use a whip, because you'll probably break the tines on the whip. But use a paddle, use small pieces when you put them in there, one at a time. Put too many in there, the paddle will just send the pieces of the frozen ice cream flying out of the bowl and ricocheting all over your kitchen, so you don't want that. And again, notice my wrist is doing all the movement. My arm isn't flapping around like I'm trying to get a butterfly stroke down pat for the Olympics. And this really only takes a matter of a few minutes, since this is sitting in a water bath, and the water bath is at almost 212 degrees. It cooks the eggs very quickly. You can see the steam rolling off. Even more so now that we have the air conditioning on, because it's a pretty hot day. And you want to make sure that you're constantly moving all of the mixture around in the bowl. You want to change your pattern of stirring, and you want to make sure that you're constantly going from one end of the bowl to the other end of the bowl, getting the sides and getting the bottom. Now, when you're doing this, you do not want to use a glass bowl, because glass can break very easily, and you're constantly beating on it with a metal whip, and it's being subjected to hot temperatures and simmering water. So don't use glass. Don't use plastic for the same reasons. Plastic can, heated that high, ooze chemicals right into your food. So you don't want to do that. Stainless steel is the best way to go. And just in a few minutes, this will be done. It's starting to seize and get thicker already. Now this will take just a touch longer to cook than it did for us to do the banana ice cream, because we added a little bit more of the strawberry liqueur in here. So that actually thinned down the eggs a bit, but that's okay. That's not going to change anything for what we're doing. All that's doing is just making it a little bit longer to cook. That's all. Now, as far as your garnishes go in this, you can use anything you want. It's totally up to you. Totally up to you. And your imagination. So if you want to put white chocolate chips in here, actual banana chips, pecans, walnuts, hazelnuts, really, it doesn't matter. Your favorite candies, you know, I mean, you got kids in the house, you can certainly take some of their favorite little candies that match up flavor-wise with this. Drop them in once this starts to cool off. You're all set and ready to rock and roll. And then once this is done, this makes for a great strawberry sundae. Chocolate sundae is part of a combination of ice creams. Very, very close to being done. We'll give it about another minute and a half, 2 minutes, and we'll be all set. One of the things you always want to make sure of is when you're doing something like this, don't cook it too long. Just turned off the induction plate. The water is more than hot enough to finish cooking it at this point, so we don't need to have that on. And you'd be surprised, just like Mommy used to make. That's why Daddy left home, so they say. All right. We are done, and we are going to shut down, take this off the fire, literally. We'll take our ring out, get rid of our pan for now, set that back. And while you're waiting with that screen, here we go, ready to rock and roll and finish it off. Now we have our base in here already. We are going to add a couple ounces of the liqueur that I just spoke of. You can see how it turns it a little bit of a color. And now we're going to finish it off. And you'll see this has got a more of an opaque pink color to it than fresh raspberries have, or excuse me, strawberries. Fresh strawberries are much deeper red, but that's the exterior. The interior is white. So when you take and you cook down strawberries, you're not going to get a deep red color. You're going to get a pink color. And this is a good pink color to work with. So we're in great shape. And just like that, we're done. And no, we didn't have to worry about the ring being on the induction plate, because as soon as you pull the pan off, it cools. And we are ready to rock and roll and add our garnishes. And it's room temperature. Okay, now we're going to add our garnishes. This is literally room temperature. We're going to add frozen strawberries that have already been chopped up to it. And the raspberry base is well adjusted and ready for this. And notice how they float. Perfect. That's exactly what we want them to do, is float. And then the second part of this little equation is we're going to add chocolate chips. And it's literally ready for the freezer. That's simple and that easy. And then after it's been in for a couple hours, we'll come back to it and give it a stir. Okay, we're going to begin our French chocolate ice cream. Now, we're going to make this a hazelnut chocolate ice cream. In the bowl, we already have vanilla and almond and lemon juice in our sugar. We're going to add some hazelnut extract. And now that this is hot, we're going to whip in our egg yolks. While this is stirring, we're going to add our heavy cream. Our heavy cream, just like our previous two ice creams, simmered and hot. This gives us a much faster cook with the eggs, speeds up our cooking time, and reduces the chances of us scrambling the eggs by cooking them too long in the water bath. We're going to make sure that we're constantly stirring this and moving it around so we don't make an omelet. And as this gets hotter and hotter, we're not going to be in a hurry to cool it off, because we've yet to add our chocolate to it. And we're going to let the heat of the base, which is the eggs and the cream, melt our chocolate right into it. And in doing so, we'll reduce the temperature of the base and make it easier to put into the freezer. Now, if you don't have hazelnut extract, you can certainly use other things like rum, or maybe triple sec, Kirschwasser, brandy, Jack Daniels. Totally up to you on how you want to do it and what you want to add to it. And you can see this is thickening up very, very quickly. It's already starting to become opaque, just like our previous batches. And we're going to add a touch more hazelnut extract. A nice strong flavor. Complement our chocolate. And we're going to be using a combination of semi-sweet chocolate and Dutch cocoa. The Dutch cocoa is 75% pure, so it's pretty strong. So we're only going to use a couple of tablespoons. And the rest of it is going to be our semi-sweet chocolate that we're going to melt right into this. This is actually a domestic semi-sweet chocolate, but still very good quality. Notice the wrist does not move much. And again, repeating the methods. Make sure that the entire bowl is stirred, one side to the other. Now, this may seem like a lot of work, but you're only moving your wrist back and forth. There's no resistance. Besides, as we all know, resistance is futile. And you can see the steam rolling off of it. So it's a really good indicator that it's cooking very easily, very evenly. Now, if there's not enough liquid in here when you're doing this, what will happen is you will scramble the eggs. If this bath is way too hot and you're not stirring it well enough, you'll scramble the eggs. So you want to make sure that you've got a lively whip. And you keep mixing. After all, this is only a few minutes. It's not a big deal. Alright. Now this isn't going to get as thick as the first batch because we used extra extracts with the hazelnut and the almond and the vanilla and the lemon juice. So this will be a little bit thinner, but that's okay when we add the chocolate to it. It'll thicken right back up again. Okay. Here goes our cocoa powder. Okay, we've taken this off of the water bath, and we still have it in our stay bowl, so we don't have to worry about holding onto the bowl. Then we're going to add our chocolate and let it melt right in. Since we don't have to worry about the mix scrambling its eggs, we don't have to worry about it stirring absolutely perfect. Now when you're dropping your chunks of chocolate in here to melt, these are thin wafers, so they'll melt relatively quick. But one thing you don't want to do is you want to get the whip and just tear it and whip around and yank in all different directions, because what will happen is you'll start splashing and you'll end up wearing it. So nice smooth strokes all the way around. And literally, just in a matter of a couple of minutes, all the chocolate is melted. The base is cooled off, and it's ready for the freezer, just like that. Now what we'll do is we'll give it a slight taste. That's definitely chocolate hazelnut. And just like that, you're done, ready for the freezer. Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to fill a pastry bag, and we're going to use our chocolate whipped cream recipe, and this is going to be used to finish off what's going to be a monster chocolate sundae. Trust me when I say nobody's got nothing on what you're about to see. Now whenever you're loading a pastry bag, always the size of your hand and never bigger. This way you can control the bag. Twist it tight and closed, It should be able to fit in the palm of your hand just like this. And that way you can control squeezing the bag with both hands. And this gives you an even way of pushing out whatever's in the bag to where you want it to be. It doesn't matter if it's buttercream, whipped cream, meringue, does not matter. In this case, our whipped cream, and this is perfect for us. We can control it with one hand and one hand, and that's exactly what you want. It should never be bigger than your base hand, no matter how big or how small your hand is. Okay, we are about to build an incredibly decadent ice cream sundae. We have chocolate hazelnut. In the middle, we have banana, and this is made with white chocolate chips, raspberry-coated almonds, and whole raspberries. And then this one on the end is triple strawberry, and this has chocolate chips in it and also whole strawberries. And we are going to decorate this, or actually garnish it, with bananas and strawberries. And we have a chocolate sauce to go with this, a Belgian chocolate sauce to go with this. And we also have some chocolate whipped cream. So, here we go. And notice that we're everything cut ahead of time. The plate has been frozen so that the chocolate ice cream in particular doesn't melt quick. That way we're not in as big a hurry to get everything organized. And what we'll do is we'll add some bananas to each end and box it in, so to speak. This way everybody, no matter what part of the plate they go for, they're going to get exactly what everyone else has. And we have our strawberries already cut up. We're going to add these all over and literally fill it in, because we know that within minutes of serving this, it's not going to look like this. It's going to be torn to pieces. Have no strawberries yet? Yeah, maybe, huh? A couple more in a couple key places and we're all set. Cool beans. That was easy, huh? Next, we're going to do our chocolate whipped cream. Now, when you're controlling a pastry bag to do this, the top of the bag, which is actually the bottom, should fit in the palm of your hand. And you should be able to hold the bag very easily, like so. All right? We'll do some very simple rosettes. And we're going to come back and we're going to do some chocolate sauce. And then we're going to garnish with blueberry maraschino cherries. And one more there. And you're probably thinking, wow, you ran out of cherries. No, he didn't. Here we go. So one more. And one and two, and we're done, just like that. We have a chocolate sundae, or if you want to call it a banana split, either way will work. And we can't really count the calories on this because I don't think there's enough digits for any calculator to do that. So if you're on a diet, this dish definitely isn't for you.